great.
We'll just go as they
are. Okay. Okay. So, ready, set.
Ready, set, go.
All right, good afternoon. I'm Mary Ellen Brown. I am an assistant professor at Arizona State University. Today I'm going to be talking to you about an innovative research-informed model for trauma prevention and intervention called the Community Resiliency Model. I'll be sharing an overview of the model and its purpose, highlighting basic elements of the model, and presenting plans for a pilot study connected to a crime reduction initiative in the Southwest United States. So to start, just a little bit of background, the zip code where Americans are born, grow, work, worship, play, and live has been found to be an illuminating predictor of lifelong health. It's been suggested it could be a stronger indicator of life expectancy than our individual genetic codes. Access to employment, education, a safe environment is dictated largely by places where people live. And health outcomes have been directly connected to the places where people live. High-stress communities are identified by quality of life indicators such as poverty, educational attainment, unemployment, neighborhood instability, crowding, linguistic isolation, and lack of access. So high-stress communities that suffer from pervasive poverty, chronic crime, and violence, in general instability, expose community members to heightened health risk related to trauma and toxic stress. Acute trauma, cumulative stress, and chronic stress are disruptive to a person's autonomic nervous system as traumatic events and stressful experiences alter breathing, heart rate, and metabolic performance. Severe and recurring dysregulation of the nervous system can lead to increased biological vulnerability, heightening a person's risk for detrimental mental, behavioral, and physical health outcomes. For populations that are socioeconomically disadvantaged, the impacts of trauma and stress are amplified as access to healthcare, treatment, and other resources are limited. Many trauma responsive programs based on neuroscience and trauma research are prohibitively expensive and can be difficult to access, especially in vulnerable communities. Resiliency theory suggests that interventions that yield increases in promotive factors help people overcome exposure to risks that could otherwise lead to negative health outcomes. The Community Resiliency Model, or CRIM, is an innovative, strengths-based, rights-based approach to trauma prevention and intervention. And the goal is to provide biologically-based mental health and coping skills interventions to improve wellness and resiliency in communities. And the approach uses a combination of education and skill building activities. It's been implemented in many settings across the world, and due to its adaptive nature, has been taught to a variety of ages and literacy levels, and holds promise as a useful intervention for individuals of different cultural and ethnic backgrounds. Despite its rising popularity and potential as an accessible, low-cost community health trauma and stress reduction intervention, there's little research to date, particularly by NIH standards. So for several years, I've been working on an initiative in Southwest US in Tucson, Arizona called Thrive in the 05. It's a crime reduction prevention initiative place-based that brings together cross-sector partners and residents to examine crimes and drivers of crimes and to propose and implement solutions. The community is predominantly Latinx and includes an urban Native American neighborhood. Through this project, it emerged that community residents would benefit from strategies to improve health and well-being and to combat the harmful risk associated with trauma and chronic stress. As such, the community selected CRIM as a strategy to promote resiliency across various age groups and cultures and Thrive in the 05. The aim of this pilot study will be to examine and measure the effectiveness of CRIM in reducing the biopsychosocial effects of stress and trauma on the health and resiliency of community members. Participants in the CRIM intervention will participate in pre and post test after 3 psychoeducational skill building sessions to assess biopsychobehavioral factors including stress, trauma, anxiety, depression, and family functioning. The initial focus population for the pilot study is school-age community youth and their caregivers. However, there's been a high demand for this intervention, not only from other residents, but even cross-sector partners. Somewhat surprisingly, the Tucson Police Department was one of our key partners that has expressed a great interest in receiving this model for their mental health support system, their intimate partner violence and sex crimes division, and to help patrol cops and first responders. But first, we'll start with the school-age youth and their caregivers. It will test the biologically-based intervention aimed at reducing trauma, improving nervous system regulation, improving mental health and overall well-being. We'll be using measures including the Harvard Trauma Questionnaire, Generalized Anxiety Disorder 7-item scale, salivary hormone testing, we get to go to spit camp, and other things to assess the biopsychobehavioral factors. Again, including stress, trauma, family functioning, anxiety, and depression. Sorry, I was rushing and then here I am. So basically, I just wanted to share this with you all, and I'd love to learn from any of you that are also engaging in this in similar type of research, or with, you know, if you'd like to learn more about the Thrive Neo5 initiative or any more about the Community Resiliency Model Trauma Resource Institute, here's some more information. This is not my style.